subscribe button and bell icon so you never miss an update from Neela Bakore Tutorials.
In the previous videos, we have seen the characteristic features of cartilaginous fishes as well as of bony fishes along with the examples. In this part, we'll talk about a comparative study of cartilaginous and bony fishes, and we are going to compare them on certain points. So let us have this tabular arrangement so that all the points are clear. So here we'll write cartilaginous fishes. So characters of cartilaginous fishes would come here, and this would be for bony fishes. Now the comparison is on these characteristics or criteria. So the first one is habitat. That means the region or the waters in which these fishes are found. Cartilaginous fishes are purely marine, whereas bony fishes are found in fresh water as well as oceans. That means they are fresh water as well as marine fishes, whereas cartilaginous fishes are purely marine. Second character is exoskeleton. In case of cartilaginous fishes, the exoskeleton is of plecoid scales. And in case of bony fishes, the scales are cycloid, ganoid, and ctenoid. So both have scales, but the scales are of different types. The third characteristic is endoskeleton. And because of this endoskeleton, they have been given this name. So here it is made up of cartilage, and in case of bony fishes, the endoskeleton is made up of bones. Now, one more comparison is the position of mouth. In case of cartilaginous fishes, they have ventral mouth. And if you remember, we made the diagram in which the mouth was here. So this is the ventral position where we make mouth. And in case of bony fishes, it is anterior mouth. So when we make the fish, the mouth is right in front. That is the anterior mouth. Let us compare it on the digestive system. In case of digestive system, we'll compare it on two points. The opening of the tract. Opening of gastrointestinal tract or the digestive system. Cartilaginous fishes have cloaca and bony fishes have anus. Cloaca is the common opening for three systems. Digestive system is one. So this is one point, and the second is scroll valve. In case of cartilaginous fishes, this scroll valve is present, and in case of bony fishes, this scroll valve is absent. So these are two points of digestive system. Now let us come to respiratory system. In respiration, again we'll compare it on couple of points. The first point is the number of gill slits. This is the first point. In case of cartilaginous fishes, they have 5 to 7 pairs of gill slits. And bony fishes have 4 pairs of gill slits. The second point is whether these gills are covered or not. Cover on gills. In case of cartilaginous fishes, there is no cover on the gill slits, whereas in case of bony fishes, operculum covers the gill slits. Related to the same, that is respiratory system, we can take one more point, that is air bladder. In case of cartilaginous fishes, this air bladder is absent. Whereas in case of bony fishes, this air bladder is present, and along with this air bladder, there are some small bony pieces which are known as Weberian ossicles. So that becomes one more point, Weberian ossicles. In case of cartilaginous fishes, as there is no air bladder, these ossicles are absent. Whereas in case of bony fishes, these small bones, which are called Weberian ossicles, are present and they connect the ear to the air bladder. So, Weberian ossicles present and connect ear to air bladder. So, this is a characteristic feature which is found in bony fishes, whereas it is not there in case of cartilaginous fishes. So, here we have compared them only on these six criteria. Now, let us take few more criteria and compare these two fishes. Let us take one more comparative thing. This is the seventh point, and we are talking about the excretory material or the nitrogenous waste which is excreted. Cartilaginous fishes are ureotelic, whereas bony fishes are ammonotelic. Next comparison is on the brain. So we will compare cerebellum and olfactory lobes. In case of cartilaginous fishes, because they have to depend more on the equilibrium part as they do not have the air bladder, their cerebellum and olfactory lobes are very large. Whereas in case of bony fishes, they are comparatively smaller. One more comparison is on the tail fin or caudal fins. In case of cartilaginous fishes, the caudal fins are heterocercal. That means the two lobes are unequal in size. Whereas in case of bony fishes, the lobes are called homocercal, and that means two lobes are of same size. When we made the diagram at that time also, like if we make cartilaginous fish, we make the ventral mouth and here is the tail fin. So we make the tail fin like this. So one lobe is larger, one lobe is smaller. Whereas in case of bony fishes, the mouth is anterior, and when we make the tail fin, both the lobes are of the same size. Here we have compared it on the gill slits also, and here we find that operculum which covers it. Whereas in this case, the gill slits are visible from outside. So this is on the tail fin. The next comparison is on dorsal fins. Dorsal fins are unpaired fins in case of cartilaginous as well as in case of bony fishes. But in case of cartilaginous fishes, there are two dorsal fins, and one, the anterior one, is larger. So here there is one dorsal fin and one smaller dorsal fin, whereas in bony fishes there is only one dorsal fin. So there is going to be one, and that too is not very big. In case of cartilaginous, that first dorsal fin is very, very prominent, and that is why many a times when we see the sharks swimming towards one direction, that pointy dorsal fin is seen above the water surface. So these are the comparative points between bony and cartilaginous fishes. So this completes our class Pisces or fishes. Now in the next part, we'll take up the next class, that is amphibia.